Crime Telangana Joint Action Committee calls a 48-hour band in Telangana. Prohibitory orders placed in Hyderabad and Secunderabad in view of the band. Now, the security has been steeped up, especially at Osmania University, which was the hotbed of the protest, in view of the past protest. Telangana supporters are going to also be holding student rallies on July 7th. There's also supposed to be a rail blockade on July 8th and 9th. Clearly, the tensions increasing now. Now, this is Telangana Joint Action Committee calling for a 48-hour band in Telangana. Prohibitory orders have been placed in Hyderabad and Secunderabad in view of the band. The security has been steeped up, especially at Osmania University, in view of the past protests. Remember, it's a 48-hour band. Tight security is there in Andhra. Telangana supporters are also planning to hold student rallies on July 7th. Let's go across to Deepthi, who joins us on the story. Deepthi, very clearly, the protests steeping, increasing up. How is the government reacting to it?
With the Telangana Joint Action Committee calling for a 48-hour Telangana band in all the 10 districts of Telangana, the life here in Telangana is completely going to be out of gear for the coming week. And with a series of agitations being planned here, we can see here in Hyderabad, the petrol stations have been shut down, educational institutions have been closed down, and the road transport has also been affected, with the state road transport taking today as an observation day. They're not plying the buses inside the city, because as the city of Hyderabad and Hyderabad and Cyberabad are under section 144 here, and considering the past history where the RTC buses have been damaged by the agitators, today they are taking as at an observation day. However, the long distance routes between Hyderabad connecting to the Simandra regions have already been cancelled, and the security here in the state has also been beefed up, considering the previous history of the violence being taken up by the agitators. However, the city is under 144, and however, there, as of now, there is no untoward incident or violence that is to be taking place here. Back to you.
Now, Deepthi, at this point of time, it's also coming when the Congress High Command needs to take some action so that these people stop the threat of quitting. How is the Congress High Command reacting to this entire band?
Exactly, with the whole intention for this band call has been to intensify the Telangana agitations in all the 10 districts of Telangana, clearly to send a message to the Congress High Command that they would not bog down, their people's movement would not be bogged down by the mere statements of Congress High Command, but they want some serious action on it. So we are also getting to know that the other political party MPs like TDP and TRS, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, and other MPs from TDP belonging to the Telangana region have also decided to submit in their resignation letters today. So seriously, the Congress High Command has some tough decisions to make as soon as possible, so that the situation does not go out of hand as of now, because the Telangana Joint Action Committee has already given a series of agitations till July 10th, where today and tomorrow it is called for a Telangana band, and the day after it is called on July 10th, it is called for a rail roko program, 8th and 9th it is called for a rail roko program, and on 10th it is called for a cooking on roads program here. So the Congress High Command needs to take a decision very soon now.
Deepthi, it's also coming at a time after 11 Congress MPs marched to the capital. They handed over their resignations. The Telangana Joint Action Committee has called for a 48-hour band. Let's also listen into reactions coming in from senior Congress leaders, Keshav Rao, as well as TRS leaders.
We are the major players, and having played a game, still you think 20. You are sitting on the sidelines and deciding on our character. Please don't do that. There is nothing like MP said. We never meant it to be said. We always spoke from our heart. It is my urge of my, the cry of my conscience. Still, I have not held any threat to any government. I am a congressman. I will die a congressman. But I want the congressman to act, the Congress party to act, Congress, the powers that be in the government to act, because we have promised them 7 years back something. And we have been talking on. So let us deliver the goods.
The people of Telangana have been resolute, and they've been wanting their public representatives to take a stand and be counted. And today we are glad that the Congress and Telugu Desam legislators and parliamentarians have come around and are trying to live up to the aspirations of the people of Telangana. We're certainly hopeful that they will actually commit themselves and they will actually get their resignations accepted, and they will fight with us all along.